ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో నెక్స్ట్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఈస్ సో మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ లైన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఫోర్స్. ఆర్ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ ఫీల్డ్ లైన్స్ just like electric lines of force, it is also magnetic lines of force or magnetic field lines. So while discussing about this, once recall electrostatics, similar topic it is. Once recall this, how can you define electric field, what are the electric lines of force, how can you define those electric lines of force? That means the force except what is a if a unit positive charge is placed in the electric field, that path followed by the unit positive charge is considered as electric lines of force. That was the imaginary lines, so that the path followed by the unit positive charge when it is placed in the electric field. So that path, whatever is the path followed by that unit charge, those are considered as electric lines of force. In the same way, here the path followed by the unit north pole when it is placed in the magnetic field. That is called magnetic lines of force. So the kind of the magnetic lines of force means it is defined as the path followed by the unit north pole, when it is the path followed by the unit north pole when it is placed in magnetic field, so that is called magnetic lines of force. The path followed by the unit north pole when it is placed in magnetic field. So, but path followed by the unit north pole, but unit north pole does not exist. Generally, unit north pole does not exist. Then how can we draw the magnetic lines of force? See here. So, let us say it is the magnet. So, this is north pole and this is south pole, north pole and south pole. If we consider the compass needle, magnetic needle must consider south pole and north pole. So when we place the magnetic needle nearer the magnets, the direction of the magnet, whatever is the direction shown by the magnetic field, if we draw that lines, those are called magnetic lines of force. We have this experiment in practicals, so there you can draw those. So that means here if you place the magnetic needle, so the path followed by the magnetic needle is like this. So here also like this, path followed by the magnetic needle. So like this, the path followed by the magnetic needle. So here, as previously we discussed, outside the magnet, the direction of magnetic lines of force are from north to south. But inside the magnet, these are from south to north. Outside, north to south, but inside, south to north. So these are the closed loops. So here, outside the magnets, so the direction of magnetic lines are the direction of magnetic lines are from north to south, but inside the magnets, they are from south to north. Outside the magnet, they are from north to south, but inside the magnet, they are from north to south. Sorry, inside the magnet, south to north. So outside the magnet, the direction of magnetic lines are from north to south, but inside the magnet, they are from south to north. So next, so the magnetic lines are closed loops. Magnetic lines are closed loops, but electric lines are not closed loops. Electric lines of force starts from the positive charge and ends at the negative charge. The starting point of the electric lines of force are from positive charge and ending point is at negative charge. They are not, the electric lines does not exist from negative to positive. Electric lines does not exist from negative to positive, but the magnetic lines of force are closed loops. Outside the magnet, they are from north to south. Outside the magnet, they are north to south, but inside they are from south to north. And these are the closed loops. And one more thing here, just like the electric lines, no two magnetic lines of force cannot intersect with each other. If they intersect with each other, at the point of intersection, we have two directions of magnetic field that does not exist. That's why no two magnetic lines of force can intersect. And next, inside the magnet, where the magnetic lines of force are very crowded, so that is a strong magnetic field. Where the magnetic lines of force are very displaced, that is the weak magnetic field. So if the number of magnetic lines of force are more, that is called strong magnetic field. If the number of magnetic lines of force are less, that is weak magnetic field. And we have one more thing, uniform magnetic field and non-uniform magnetic field. So like this, uniform means magnetic lines of force are uniform per unit area, but non-uniform means they are varying from place to place. So that is uniform magnetic field and non-uniform magnetic field. So these are the magnetic lines of force. Major important role in these two is these two points, very important. Magnetic lines of force, outside the, how can we draw the magnetic lines of force? The path followed by the unit north pole, the path followed by the unit north pole when it is placed in external magnetic field. But unit north pole does not exist for us. That's why the path followed by the compass needle, yes, it is a magnetic needle. The whatever is the direction shown by the magnetic needle, so that these are the direction of magnetic lines of force. So next, here come to the point, what is magnetic flux? It is also denoted with phi, just like electric flux, magnetic flux, electric flux, same topics. How can you define electric flux generally? How can you define electric flux? The number of electric lines of force crossing normal per unit area, that is called electric flux. Number of electric lines of force crossing normal to the unit area. So for example, so this is the situation. Let us say this is the surface. This is the surface. If the magnetic, this is the surface. If the lines of force are existing like this, that is not the flux. If the lines of force entering normal to the surface, entering or leaving, that is considered as flux. So this is certain area, this is certain area. So the lines enter, the lines emitting normal to the surface, the lines emitting normal to the surface, how many lines emitting normal to the surface, that is called flux, electric flux, here also the magnetic flux. The number of magnetic lines of force, so the definition is the number of magnetic lines of force emitting normal to given cross section, given cross sectional area. So that is called magnetic flux. The number of magnetic lines of force are magnetic lines emitting normal to the given, normal to the given cross sectional area, emitting normal to the given cross sectional area, that is called, what is that, magnetic flux. So for example, these are the magnetic lines, let us say these are the magnetic lines, this like this. So for example, this is the cross sectional area. So cross sectional area, magnetic lines emitting normal to the surface, magnetic lines emitting normal to the surface. So this is the situation. So here phi can be written as magnetic flux integral of B bar dot ds, where B is intensity of magnetic field, intensity of magnetic field, and ds is aerial vector. Or cross sectional area, B bar is the intensity of magnetic field, ds bar is the aerial vector. Then from this phi can be written as integral of bds cos theta, dot product of, it is the dot product of B bar dot ds bar. So that is why bds cos theta. Here theta is, in this situation theta is equals to 0, where theta is, how can you calculate theta here? Theta, this is the direction of the aerial vector, let us say ds bar, that is the direction of the ds bar. So the theta is angle between the aerial vector and the direction of the magnetic lines. Theta is the angle between the direction of the aerial vector and the direction of the magnetic lines. So here theta is, both are in the same direction, that is theta equals to 0. That is why phi can be written as integral of, simply it is bds, phi is equals to integral of bds. But here let us say these are the magnetic lines, if the aerial vector will be like this, let us say this is the ds bar and it makes, this is the direct, it makes an angle theta here. So that is why here we can write phi is equals to integral of b ds cos theta. Or b cos theta into ds, anything we can write, b cos theta into ds. So from this we can write integral of b bar dot ds bar. So in the direction of normal to the direction of the aerial, the number of magnetic lines emitting normal to the given area, number of magnetic lines emitting normal to the given area, that is integral of bds, or phi can be written as bds cos theta. So this is the magnetic flux. If the number of lines emitting through the area is more, the flux is more. If the number of lines emitting the area is less, the flux is less. So here this is the magnetic flux, same as that of electric flux. In electric flux we get same formula, electric flux can be written as integral of eds cos theta or integral of e bar dot ds bar, integral of e bar dot ds bar, like this. What is this symbol, circle? closed path. So that is next here. What is a unit? Unit of magnetic flux is Weber. Unit of magnetic flux is Weber, or this is Newton per ampere meter into meter square, or according to this, Newton per ampere meter, unit of magnetic field is Newton per ampere meter into circular meter square, meter meter cancel, so that is Newton meter per ampere, Newton meter per ampere. But don't write like this, because this is the scalar quantity. Magnetic flux is the scalar quantity, but magnetic field intensity is the vector quantity. So that's why we must write only Weber. This is the SI unit, and CGS unit is Maxwell. SI unit is the Weber and CGS unit is the Maxwell. So 1 Weber is equals to 1 Weber is equals to 10 to the power of 8 Pascal, sorry, 10 to the power of 8 Maxwell. So this is the unit. 1 Weber is equals to 10 to the power of 8 Maxwell, 10 to the power of 8 Maxwell. And its dimensional formula based on this, Newton meter, m l t power minus 2 l divided by a, so that is m l square t power minus 2 a power minus 1. Newton meter is also considered as joule, or it is joule per ampere. Newton is force, meter is displacement, force into displacement, nothing but joule. Joule per ampere also is the unit. So this is magnetic flux, magnetic lines of force and magnetic flux. Unit is Weber and it is Maxwell. 1 Weber equals to 10 to the power of 8 Maxwell, like this. So next, come to the point. Here we have to calculate intensity of magnetic field on axial line of bar magnet. Intensity of magnetic field on the axial line of the bar magnet. So we calculated already in electrostatics intensity of electric field on the axial line of the electric dipole. Same, what is that formula? Their intensity can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by r cube or d cube, whatever it is. To be, this is the intensity of electric field on the axial line of the dipole, where P is the dipole moment. Same it is also here, also we can calculate the same. So let us say this is south pole and this is north pole. Let us say the line passing through the south pole and north pole is called axial line. The line passing through this magnet is called axial line. Let us say certain point here from the center, let us say it is the distance d, and length of the magnet is 2l. So from north pole, what is the distance? It is d minus l. So from south pole, the distance is d plus l. From the north pole, the distance between the point P and north pole is d minus l. From south pole, the distance is d plus l. This total length is 2l. This is l and this is also l. So this is l. This total is d. That's why d minus l. This is d plus l. So here, magnetic field due to north pole at point P. So let us say B1 is equals to mu naught by 4 pi. Pole strength is M divided by distance D minus L whole square. So magnetic field due to the isolated pole. So what is the direction it is? While calculating the magnetic field, we must consider unit north pole. So that's why it is also north pole, north, north repulsion. Let us say it is B1. Direction is away from north pole. Next, write down that magnetic field due to south pole at point P. Magnetic field due to south pole at point P. So that B2 is equals to mu naught by 4 pi. So M by, so D plus L whole square. So the distance between these two is D plus L. So the direction is, this is south pole. Here we must consider unit north pole. South pole, north pole, attraction. So that is B2. So that is towards north pole. Here it is away from north pole and it is towards north pole. Both are in opposite direction. Here B1 and B2 must be in opposite direction. If B1 and B2 are in opposite direction, means definitely net magnetic field is B net is equals to B1 difference B2. So which one is more here? So denominator is, it is D minus L, it is D plus L. Definitely this one is more. So that is B1 minus B2. B1 minus B2. So that is mu naught by 4 pi M by D minus L whole square minus mu naught by 4 pi M by, so D plus L whole square. So that is mu naught by 4 pi M common 1 by D minus L whole square minus 1 by D plus L whole square. So that is mu naught M by 4 pi D minus L whole square into D minus L D plus L whole square. So D plus L whole square minus D minus L whole square. So that is mu naught M by 4 pi mu naught M by 4 pi. So D square plus L square, A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square. So that is 4DL divided by D square minus L square whole power 4. Here if D is very much greater than L, then L must be neglected here. T must be very much greater than L, L must be neglected. So that is mu naught M by 4 pi 4DL divided by D power 4. So that is mu naught M by 4 pi. So here 2L into 2 divided by D cube, D by D power 4. So therefore net magnetic field is equals to mu naught by 4 pi 2 into M into 2L divided by D cube. So that is equals to mu naught by 4 pi 2M by D cube. B net. So net magnetic field is equals to mu naught by 4 pi 2m by d cube. Mu naught by 4 pi 2m by d cube. So that is intensity of the magnetic field on axial line of the bar magnet. Axial line of the bar magnet. What is capital M here? Magnetic moment of the magnet. Magnetic moment is defined as pole strength into length. Pole strength into length, that is mu naught by 4 pi 2 m by d cube. Mu naught by 4 pi 2 m by d cube. What is the direction here? What is the direction? B1 is away from North Pole and B2 is towards North Pole. But net magnetic field, the B1 is greater than B2. That means net magnetic field must be in the direction of B1. Net magnetic field must be in the direction of B1. So, if the net magnetic field is in the direction of B1, what we can do? So, this B1 is away. So, resultant B net is also in the direction of B1. See here. B1 is this direction, B2 this direction. Resultant B1 minus B2. Why we are writing B1 minus B2? B1 is greater than B2. So, that is why. That means net magnetic field also must be in the direction of B1. What is the direction of B1? This is the direction of B1. So, that direction is nothing but the direction of the magnetic moment. The direction of magnetic moment is south to north. Direction of magnetic moment is south to north. So, that is. So, here the direction of the net magnetic field, B net in this direction, B net must be in the direction of, B net must be in the direction of magnetic moment. B net must be in the direction of magnetic moment in case of axial line of the bar magnet. In case of axial line of the bar magnet. So, in electrostatics also we did the same. There we got 2 p by d cube, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 p by d cube, same derivation. And the direction of the electric field on the axial line of the dipole is in the direction of dipole moment. Here also B net must be in the direction of magnetic moment. So, that is. So, that is on the axial line it is. But equatorial line. So, the derivation must be the same. No need to derive this. In IP point of view also. So, the derivation of the electric field is necessary. The derivation of the magnetic field and the axial line and equatorial line is not necessary. So, if it is necessary, replace that P and it is M. That's all. So, magnetic field, just we can discuss about on equatorial line. On equatorial line, let us say, so this is South Pole and this is North Pole. Here, this is the equatorial point. Equatorial point. So, while calculating the magnetic field, we must consider unit north pole. So, north north repulsion in this direction and south north attraction in this direction. So, the net magnetic field must be in this direction. See here. So, there is a B due to north pole and it is B due to south pole. B due to north pole and it is B due to south pole, and this is the direction of the net magnetic field. So, here after calculating B net on axial line can be written as mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube only, mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube. And here, so the direction of magnetic field must opposite to the direction of magnetic moment, opposite to the direction of magnetic moment on equatorial line. But on the axial line this direction must be in the direction of magnetic moment. So, net magnetic field on axial line is in the direction of the magnetic moment, but here on equatorial line the direction of B must be opposite to the direction of the magnetic moment, opposite to the direction of the magnetic moment. So, this is the situation here. So because of this, why it is opposite means, see here, this is repulsion, this is attraction. The resultant magnetic field must be like this. So next, at any position, this is important. Magnetic intensity of the magnetic field at any position due to bar magnet. See here. This is the bar magnet at south pole and it is north pole. At this point, we have to calculate, let us say, from center of the magnet. Let us say it is the point P. It is at a distance D. And here it makes an angle theta. The line joining the center of the magnet, the line joining the center of the magnet to the point P makes an angle theta. The line joining the center of the magnet and the point P makes an angle theta. So now for our convenience, this dipole can be divided into two conditions. So this dipole moment M is the dipole moment, that can be divided into two conditions. So let us say one is like this, another one is like this. This is south, north, and this is south, north. So let us say it is the first position and it is the second position. So this is actually, this is the direction of the magnetic moment. It makes an angle theta. So that's why it can be divided into two components, M cos theta, M sin theta. Magnetic moment can be divided into two components, M cos theta and M sin theta. So this is M cos theta and this is M sin theta. See here, this is M, this is the direction of M. So this is the direction of, it is M cos theta, and this is the direction of M sin theta. Magnetic moment is a vector quantity. So that's why this can be divided into two components, M cos theta, M sin theta. So now, for the first position of the magnets, for the first position of magnets, the point P is, the point P is axial point. For the first position of the magnet, for the first position of the magnet, the point P is axial point. So that's why, B1 can be written as an axial point, mu naught by 4 pi. What is the formula of the axial point magnetic field? 2m by d cube. Here 2m cos theta by d cube. Why we are writing m cos theta? In this direction, the magnetic moment is m cos theta. For the first position of the magnet, the point P is the axial point. So for that position, B1 is mu naught by 4 pi, 2m cos theta by d cube. Next, for second position, for the second position, so this is the second position. Second position of magnets, the point P is equatorial point. So this is axial point and this is the magnet, perpendicular to the magnet, that is equatorial point. So that's why from that we can write B2 can be written as mu naught by 4 pi. What is the magnetic field on the equatorial line? M by d cube. But it is M sin theta by d cube. So these are the two conditions. And what is the direction of the magnetic field directions here? On the axial line at the point P, the direction of the magnetic field is in the direction of the magnetic moment. This is B1 bar. And on the axial line, the direction of the magnetic field is in the direction of magnetic moment. This is south, south north, this is the direction. On the axial line, the direction of the magnetic field is in the direction of magnetic moment. But it is the equatorial line. for this magnet, this is equatorial point. For equatorial point, this is the direction. For equatorial point, the direction of magnetic field is opposite to the direction of magnetic moment. Opposite to the direction of magnetic moment, that is B2. So here B1 and B2 are perpendicular. So the resultant is B. B is equals to, we can write it as under root B1 square plus B2 square. B is equals to under root, we can write B1 square plus B2 square, because the angle between B1 bar and B2 bar is 90. So B is equals to under root B1 is mu naught by 4 pi. So 2m cos theta by d cube whole square plus this is mu naught by 4 pi m sin theta by d cube. So from this B can be written as mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube common, whole square common, that comes out of the root, that is 2 cos theta whole square, that is 4 cos square theta plus sin square theta. So therefore B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube under root 3 cos square theta plus cos square theta plus sin square theta. So that is B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube under root 3 cos square theta plus 1. This is the resultant magnetic field at any point due to the magnets. Resultant magnetic field at any point due to the magnet B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube square root of 3 cos square theta plus 1. If theta equals to 0, that becomes axial point. Cos 0 is 1, 3 plus 1, 4, root 4 is 2. So that is 2 m by d cube. See here. If theta is equals to 0, that is called axial point, or that is axial line. Then B can be written as mu naught by 4 pi square root of mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube under root 3 plus 1. Theta equals to cos 0 1. So that is mu naught by 4 pi. It becomes 2 m by d cube. So that is the magnetic field on the axial line of the bar magnet. Next here, if theta is equals to 90, so that is equatorial point. If theta equals to 90. So for example, if the point is at this position, if it is at this position, then this theta becomes 90. So that is equatorial point. Then B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube under root 1, because cos 90 is 0. So that becomes mu naught by 4 pi. So that is m by d cube. So this is the verification. And we got axial point is 2 m by d cube, equatorial point is m by d cube. This is the verification of this. Now in this situation, here bit is B1, and here B2 can be written as mu naught by 4 pi m sin theta by d cube. See here, let us say the resultant magnetic field makes an angle alpha here. Here let us say the resultant magnetic field B makes an angle alpha, then we can write alpha at this position, alpha with B1 bar. Then tan alpha can be written as opposite side, let us say it is this opposite side. Tan alpha can be written as opposite side by adjacent side. So that is, we can write B2 by B1. Tan alpha is equals to opposite side by adjacent side, B2 by B1. What is the value of B2 here? Mu naught by 4 pi m sin theta by d cube divided by mu naught by 4 pi 2 m cos theta by d cube, m sin theta by d cube divided by 2 m cos theta by d cube. Mu naught by 4 pi d cube cancel, m also cancel. So then tan alpha is equals to half tan theta. Tan alpha is equals to half tan theta. What is theta here? Theta is the angle initial situation. What that angle between the line joining the point P and the magnetic moment. Line joining the point P and the magnetic moment, that is theta. So, and alpha is the resultant magnetic field. So now total angle made by the resultant magnetic field with horizontal, that is equals to theta plus alpha. Total angle made by the, this is the resultant magnet. Finally, we got the magnetic field is B. This makes an angle alpha here, and this one makes an angle theta. So total angle is theta plus alpha. Total angle made by the resultant magnetic field with the horizontal. This is theta and this is alpha. Theta plus alpha. In this situation, what is the relation between theta and alpha? So we must write tan alpha is equals to half tan theta. Relation between theta and alpha is tan alpha must be equal to half tan theta. So this is in electrostatics also we derived this situation, and this is the direction of the resultant intensity of electric field. Same situation we got, tan alpha equals to half tan theta, and total angle made with the horizontal is theta plus alpha. If this condition exists, then the total angle made with the horizontal is theta plus alpha. If the total angle made with the horizontal theta plus alpha is mentioned, then what is the relation between alpha and theta? Tan alpha is equals to half tan theta. So this is the situation. Resultant magnetic field due to the bar magnet at any position. So resultant magnetic field formula is B is equals to mu naught by 4 pi m by d cube under root 3 cos square theta plus 1. This is the magnetic field direction, resultant magnetic field and its directions, and the relation between those two angles. So this is the condition.